Welcome to the spoken tutorial on customization of dSpace homepage. In this tutorial, we will learn to change dSpace logos, modify the dSpace banner, and update the news sections. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, dSpace version 6.3, Gedit text editor, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other text editor or browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed dSpace version 6.3 on your system, Tomcat service running, administrator authority in dSpace, and a working internet connection. Prerequisites. You should be familiar with basic Linux commands and HTML tags. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. The files and commands used in this tutorial are available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the files before practicing. dSpace is a highly customizable software application. We can customize the dSpace user interface and its behavior as per our preference. The user interface of dSpace can be modified for branding of a repository, communicate vision mission of the organization, enhance aesthetics and usability, present tooltip or help to use. Now, let us understand the different sections of the dSpace homepage. Open a web browser. In the address bar, type localhost:8080 and press enter. dSpace interface opens. We have a navigation bar logo located at the top left corner. Below that, we have the banner section. The dSpace logo is located next to the banner. Below the banner section, we have a green color bar called breadcrumb bar. Below the breadcrumb bar, we have top news and sidebar news sections. Let us begin with the customization of the dSpace navigation bar logo. These are the properties for the logo. We will replace this default logo with the new one. Make sure that the new logo has the same properties if you are using your own logo. Open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt and T keys together. Here onwards, please press the Enter key after typing each command. Go to the folder where you downloaded the images. Mine is in the Downloads folder. Then, we will move the logos folder to the dSpace users home folder. To do so, we will type the command as shown. If prompted, type the admin password and press enter. Now, login as dSpace user by typing sudo space su space hyphen space dSpace. If prompted, type the admin password and press enter. The source code for dSpace is located in dSpace-6.3-src-release directory. If we wish to customize dSpace, then we have to make changes in this directory. We will first change the current working directory to the dSpace image directory. So on the terminal, type the command shown here. Let us rename the default dSpace navigation bar logo for backup purposes. To do so, we type the command as shown here. If prompted, type the dSpace user password and press enter. My new logo is in the home directory of dSpace user on my machine. Let us copy and paste that inside the dSpace image directory. To do so, I will type the command as shown here. Next, we have to rebuild DSpace to update these changes. To do so, type the command as shown. Rebuild process will take some time depending upon your internet speed. On successful completion, build successful message will be displayed. Now, switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The old navigation bar logo is replaced with the new one. In case if you cannot see the updated logo, kindly clear the cache and refresh the page. Next, let us try to add our logo instead of the DSpace logo next to the banner section. These are the properties of the logo. We will replace this default logo with our own logo. Make sure that the new logo has the same properties if you are using your own logo. Let us rename the existing logo for backup purposes. To do so, type the command as shown in the terminal. Copy the new logo from home directory of DSpace user to DSpace image directory. To do so, type the command as shown here. Now, rebuild DSpace to update the changes. The build is successful as indicated by the success message. Now, switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The DSpace logo next to the banner section is replaced with the new one. The DSpace banner is used for branding of repositories. Let us proceed to modify the banner content now. Messages.properties is a file which contains user interface text of DSpace. Let us open this file. To do so, type the command as shown. Messages.properties file contains key value pairs. Keys are referenced from JSP files and the corresponding value is rendered in UI. Scroll down and locate the key jsp.layout.header-default.brand.heading. Change its default value to IITB repository. Basic HTML tags such as heading can be used to write value. If you wish to display the text in a stylish way, we can use those HTML tags also. For example, I can type the value as shown. Now, locate the key jsp.layout.header-default.brand.description. Change its default value as shown. Save and close the file. Now, rebuild DSpace to update the changes. Build is successful as indicated by the on-screen message. Now switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The banner section content is updated. Top news and sidebar news are used to display updates and news about the repository. We will edit these in the front end itself with the help of an administrator. Click on the Sign On To button at the top right corner. From the drop down, select My DSpace. Log into DSpace with your administrator's email address and password. For this demonstration, I will log in with the administrator's email ID dspace.u1@gmail.com. My DSpace page appears on the screen. Click on the down arrow at the top right corner next to the admin's mail ID. Then select Administer. We will be redirected to the admin interface. On the top navigation bar, click on General Settings menu. Then select Edit News from the drop-down. Select Top News in the News Editor section to edit Top News. Click on the Edit button. News editor page opens for the top news with default DSpace top news. You can use HTML tags in the news editor. I am updating the top news as shown. Click on the Save button. Likewise, I will edit the sidebar news. Click on the Save button. In the top navigation bar, click on the menu Home. The top news and sidebar news section for DSpace homepage is updated. Likewise, we can customize our DSpace homepage based on our needs. Log out from DSpace interface. Switch to the terminal. Type logout to exit from DSpace user login. With this, we come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to change DSpace logos, modify DSpace banner, and update news sections. As an assignment, change navbar logo and DSpace logo. Modify the DSpace banner content. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. The Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.